click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see the truth table and working principle of a JK flip-flop. We have discussed SR flip-flop and we know that last row of SR flip-flop is nothing but the prohibited state which cannot be used. So that is a drawback associated with the SR flip-flop. So that drawback can be overcome by using JK flip-flop. So in this video we will see how to design JK flip-flop so that the last row can be utilized. So here we have a diagram for a JK flip-flop where you can see SR flip-flop is connected with two more AND gate where J and K are given as an input. So basically in JK flip-flop your S is nothing but this input is equal to J into Q bar and R is equal to K into Q where Q and Q bar are outputs of SR flip-flop. So basically the past output, that means output of SR flip-flop, are connected as an input. So we called it as a sequential circuit. So along with the J and K flip-flop, these two input are also important to decide the state of the flip-flop. Clock is provided to SR flip-flop. So let's discuss the truth table of JK flip-flop. So first here we have written, since we have both the inputs are active, that is J, K, S and R, and Qn and Qn bar stands for the past output which are connected as an input. So here we have a Q bar and here we have a Q. So in first case J and K both are equal to 0. Similarly S and R both are equal to 0. Now we all know what is the SR flip-flop truth table is. So SR truth table says that if S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0, Qn plus 1, that is the present output, is remain as a past output. If S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, it is said to be set. When S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1, it's said to be reset, and for 1, 1, it is undefined. So we are checking the JK especially for this last state. So for the first three row, it will remain same. The JK flip-flop will remain same as SR flip-flop. So here since we have S and R both are equal to 0, if both are equal to 0, output should be remain at Qn, and here the Qn is equal to 0. So my output will be 0. That is the first case verified. Second, here J and K both are equal to 0. Now here S is equal to 1 is given. If S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, the output will remain set, that is equal to 1. So here I have written it is equal to 1. Now if you check this 0 and 1, this 0 and 1 are nothing but the state Qn. So for the first case it is remain Q. So we can write that output for this two input is remain as a Qn. So that is nothing but the first state of SR flip-flop. So the first row of SR and JK will remain same, and that state is called as a no change state. Now next case where J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 0. For that S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. If S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0, that means this belongs to the set condition and the output will come out as a 1. So here output I have written is equal to 1. Similarly, the second case you have S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 0. If S and R are equal to 0, the output will be past output, that is Qn. So here Qn is equal to 1. So this Qn has been mapped as the output of a JK flip-flop, that is 1. So if the output is remain at a 1, that means this flip-flop will remain in a set condition. So for 1, 0, that is J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 0, your output will be 1 and JK flip-flop will be remain in a set condition. Now let's check the third one. Third, in J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 1. Here S is equal to 0, 0. If S is equal to 0, 0, for 0, 0, output is equal to Qn. And for this condition, Qn is equal to 0. So here output has written is equal to 0. In second case, for J is equal to 0, K is equal to 1. S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. If R is equal to 1, that means the reset condition. So for reset, output remains 0. So here you are getting both the output 0 for both condition, where S and R having a different value, then this condition of a JK flip-flop is called as a reset condition. The fourth one, which is the important one. So if you see, these three rows remain same, that is a no change, set and reset. Now we are more interested in what will happen if both the input J and K will remain at a one position, because in SR flip-flop, this condition is prohibited. And that is considered as a drawback. Now here J is equal to 1, K is equal to 1, S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 0. If S is equal to 1, that means flip-flop should be in a set condition and Q should be equal to 1. So here Q is equal to 1. But if you check the past output, that is equal to 0. That means you are getting the inversion of the past output. Similarly, in the second case, J and K are 0. But S is equal to 0 and R is equal to 1. If R is equal to 1, that means it is a reset condition. Output will be 0. That is the present output. But if you check the past output, you have a 1. So that means if you consider this state and the output state, this is your past output state and this is the present output state. So present output is the inversion of a past output. Here also the present output is the inversion of the past output. So this state is known as a toggle state because you are getting the output is equal to Qn bar. So let's write the truth table of a JK flip-flop again. For a 0, 0, my output is unchanged, that is Qn. For J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 0, the flip-flop will be in a set condition. That means output will remain as a 1. If J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 1, it will be reset condition. So here output will be equal to 0. And for 1, 1, you will get output is equal to Qn bar. Now, here you can see the last condition, that is a 1-1 condition, the drawback of SR flip-flop is overcome because this state can be used as a toggle state. But in a SR flip-flop, we have seen that was a drawback, it was a prohibited, so that state was the waste. So here we can reutilize the last row of the SR flip-flop, and that is how JK flip-flop can be designed. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Do subscribe Ikeda. Thank you so much.